All right, all right. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Jack Tasty Experience. I'm running a little bit behind today. The whole band is here waiting, ready to play some good music for you. So we're going to, we got a segment today with Miss Steph. She's going to be doing some hot bands. You got to check that out. Dan and Juan, they're going to be doing some guitar talk. That's a great segment. A few other things going on, but for right now, we're going to play you some music. So y'all stick around and check out the show today. All right, y'all, this one's called Southern Style. Let me do that again. All right, y'all, this one's called Southern Style.
Close up shop at Beer 30. Worked hard all day, damn, I'm thirsty. Then I jump in the truck and I head up to the quicksand. Picked up some smokes and a 12-pack. Gotta get home, won't see my baby. Gotta get home, won't see that girl. Gotta get home, won't see my baby. Cooking up some grub. Baby on the front porch, just soaking in a tub. She sure looks good and she's sexy, of course. But when I get home, she'll be right my home. Gotta get home, won't see my baby. Gotta get home, won't see that girl. Gotta get home, won't see my baby.
What's up? It's Jack Tasty here with you. Man, I got to tell you about the microphones that we use on stage. We love Shure microphones. We got others, but these are our go-tos.
One main reason is they are industry standard. Some of the best and have been used forever. If you need one, you can always find one at your local music store, your online music store. They'll get them to you fast. We always use Shure. Thank you, Shure. Ba-da-bum, Mikey.
Hey, everyone. Sorry. Drinking. This is Mike, Jack Tasty Band, Jack Tasty Experience. And we want to do something. We want to talk about all the local bands around here that we like going and seeing. We want to promote them. We want you to go out and see them, because going to see live music, going to see local bands, supporting them, supports all of us. So,
yes, it does.
Let's talk about it. Let's. Stephanie put this list together. And so we're going to let her talk about the first band that's on the list.
I will go with my favorite one, and we did see them not long ago. We love them. That was Incognito.
They were
Incognito.
Awesome.
That is with
we saw them at the Revel.
Yeah, we saw them at the
Revel. At the Revel, Missy St. Thomas.
Or Revel. Is it Revel or Revel?
Revel.
It's whatever
Revel,
you want to call it.
Whatever. Okay. It's in Frisco, right?
In Frisco. In Frisco. We know that word.
Yeah.
Or Frisco.
No, well, yeah.
Yeah, she does some great heart tributes. I mean, it is just
great band to go see. Probably the best guitar player in Texas I've ever seen.
She changes up her outfits. It's an awesome show to see. They're going to be playing on 224 at the Poor Shack, so go out and see them.
Go see them. Look them up.
Cool.
Scott, what about the next band?
All right, the next one, Inhalin. This is a Van Halen tribute band. I am a huge Van Halen fan way back from old school, all the way back in the day. And so this is at 218 O'Shea's is where we're going on February the 18th.
And
so,
that's actually Incognito. The guys that are in Incognito are in Halen.
Man, I didn't know that.
Yeah, just minus Missy.
Yeah.
Wow, that is super
so
cool.
So go see them awesome. Too. They put on a great Van
Thank
Halen
you.
Show.
He sounds exactly like David Lee Roth.
Does
exactly.
a great performance of Van Halen, of David Lee Roth, and we saw him do some of that when we saw Incognito.
Very cool.
So next we've got the Lone Star Skynyrd. Guessing that is a Lynyrd Skynyrd tribute band. I think a Larry, bass player
this
Larry,
is
that
wild man
we
Larry.
All know and love.
Larry and Susan. Yes. Way
Larry
to go,
Susan.
Larry
yes.
and Susan.
Yeah, man. They just won big time in Nashville, Tennessee. Best tribute band annual of the year.
Wow.
Something like, I mean, this was a major award.
Major.
That's good for
big,
them.
Big, big,
man. And they just got engaged.
Oh, cool.
The band got engaged to who?
No, Larry and Susan.
Oh. Oh, that's great.
And they're going to be playing with Desperado, so you don't want to miss that one at all.
Yeah, cool. And that's going to be on the 4th of March, and that's at Lava Cantina in the Colony. Great venue, Lava Cantina.
Cool.
My bad.
next one all is right. Down and Out. That's my friend Will Kincaid, and he is a George Strait
no,
tribute
okay.
band. He's amazing. Go out and see him. He's going to be a little far out there
out
on the 17th. He's going to be at Jake's and Denison.
Hmm. Great.
Jake's and Denison. Like that.
Shout
Jake's
out
Burgers.
To Jake's.
But Jake's Burgers, right?
I assume. I don't know.
Man, I don't think so.
Man,
Jake's got
I'm
some
there.
Good burgers, man. They got what's it called? A Flaming Rooster sandwich. Woo, man. You got to check that out.
Woo.
That is Jack Tasty Chicken Sandwiches, baby.
There you go.
I ain't lying. Got to go check that out at Jake's. All right. Emerald City.
Yeah.
Emerald City.
Wow, never
March.
Heard of them.
Okay, right?
Said no one ever.
Emerald City. And I just saw them on New Year's Eve, and it was freaking amazing. We're at Los Anatole. It's huge. This is just a huge show. Seriously, it's massive. A massive show. So you got to go check them out. They're always good. That's on March 10th at the Revel. Revel. I think it's Revel, dude. I don't know what you call it.
Revel.
I call
fine,
it Revel.
Revel.
Tomato, tomato.
I'm British.
I'm going with Revel. So, all right.
I saw Emerald Town. I never saw Emerald City.
Oh.
No.
That was March 10th.
March 10th.
At Rebel right. Revel.
Next one. Who's
Next
up?
Next one. We got Southern Glory. We all know Southern
yeah,
Glory,
yeah,
right?
That's my homeboys there.
Great.
Love those guys.
That's a great band. They do great Southern rock. And they're going to be playing on the 4th of March at Char Bar Grill.
Yeah.
And that's in Sachse.
Oh man, you got me. Charbar Grill. I think that's the new one in Edge of Saxony.
Is it?
Is that right? I think.
It sounds saxy.
It sounds saxy.
I bet it's a saxy place.
Oh Lord.
Man.
We're gonna throw another one out there. Back in Black. That's Steve Wilson. He used to play with Shane in some bands when they were younger.
Shane.
Tell us, Shane, who's what Shane? Date are they playing? We need to know this.
Dude, so, Shane, do you know where they're playing? When they're playing?
Look them up.
No?
Look them up, or to be continued, we'll let you know where they're going to play. There's an Aerosmith tribute band that's playing on March 3rd at Legacy Hall. They're called Walk This Way.
And don't forget, Back in Black's got a great documentary on Amazon.com you can rent. It's amazing.
I will go check that one out.
Dude, you have to rent it, but I'll write it off.
I'm a documentary. Documentary guy. All right, what do we got? Led Zeppelin tribute.
Battle of Evermore.
Battle of Evermore. That's cool. Never heard these guys, girls, whoever this is. Don't know, but I'm a huge Zeppelin fan.
It's got to be great.
That is March the 10th. This, once again, is at Legacy Hall. So, once again, local to DFW. That's where we're local right now. I promise you next time we're going to bring you some local stuff that's going to be wherever you are, California, Florida, Nebraska, somewhere. We're going to be doing a little more research, a little more legwork. We're going to find some other cool bands. And y'all chime in and let us know if you got something around town that you, a cool band you love, throw it at us, man. We'll pitch it for you. That's what we want to do here. This is our little bit, our little segment. And it's really actually Steph's segment. So
it's our
pop bands. We're just along for the ride. So
that's what we're doing. And we're just kind of jumping in and stealing our show.
And if you're coming to Dallas, if you are from somewhere else, you're going to come visit Dallas. We want to give you some ideas where you can go to see some great local music. A lot of good bands in this area. And we are very lucky to have the amount of facilities and venues so that we can go out and play. You can come out and see us, or you can see any of these other great bands that are out there playing.
Absolutely. And last but not least, you want to jump on this
Almost
one?
Last but not least, our very own Juan is
playing.
Juan is playing
he
on 224.
One.
He's going to be at Wine Authority on 224. I'm not sure. Are you going to be anywhere sooner than
Where's
that?
Where's Wine Authority at?
In Richardson.
It's
Richardson,
in Richardson,
Texas.
Y'all hear that?
Canyon Creek.
That's in Texas. Cool. You're somewhere else.
And I know Mike wants to mention, me and Mike do love the Beatles, so we didn't want to
leave
this one out.
We do love the Beatles. I just got back from Vegas, saw Beatles Love. It's amazing. If you're from Vegas, go see it. If you're going to Vegas, go see it. But a local band, about to celebrate their 20th anniversary. They're called Hard Night's Day. That'll be on April 1st at the Rustic. And check out the Rustic.
We want to play the Rustic.
We
want to
play
a very
the
cool
Rustic.
Place.
That has got our name written all
it
over
it. It does, man. I love that
place.
Because
I'm very rustic.
Love the food, too, by the way. The food is jack-tasty.
Yes, so, the food looks very jack-tasty.
Yeah, that's a good place.
So
man.
Make sure
it.
You check them out, okay?
It's an outdoor stage.
Great show.
Really cool.
If you love the Beatles, even if you don't, they're a really good band to go see. Been together a long time. And they play all over the nation. They don't just play local. So.
Awesome. Awesome. Now let's see if we can cut to some live music somewhere. We got either somebody, us, we're coming up, or we got somebody recorded that's coming up somewhere, a bar somewhere. One of these bands, we're going to go check them out. We're taking a field trip.
Yes! Wait a minute. I got to get a permission slip signed.
Oh, okay.
My mom's got to sign
we'll
that for me.
We'll forge the signature.
Yeah, would you? Well. Yeah.
But we're gonna take a field trip, and we're going to see somebody live, and we're going to record that and bring that to you on the next one. Right, Steph?
That's right. Stephanie reminding you to support your local music.
Yeah, buddy.
Thank you.
Jake Tyson.
See you.
Out. All right, everybody. Let's get ready to hear Mike sing Dance the Night Away.
You're old enough to be there. But lady go, she's on fire. Dancing gets her higher than anything else she knows. Ooh, baby, baby. Take a look my way. Ooh, baby, baby. Well, you're scared romance, cause you're old.
Really?
Three.
Hey, everyone, this is Mike with the Jack Tasty Experience.
JT.
What's up, everybody?
Hey, everyone.
What's up, everybody?
Oh, boy. We're having a good time here playing some music for y'all and some other stuff. But right now, we want to talk to y'all about movies that rock. And these are some of our favorite movies. Hopefully, if it's some of yours, let us know. If you got some other ones in mind we don't mention, let us know about those, too. We'll talk about them. We're easy, right?
Easy? I may be easy, but I ain't cheap.
Like Sunday morning.
Really?
Ain't cheap, baby.
You're doing this for free. So
only for a little while.
So let's talk a little bit about movies that rock. And we can talk about any of them. I put up a list of five, and these are probably ones that stick out in my mind the most. So The Doors. With the great Val Kilmer.
Yeah, Val Kilmer, great
yeah,
one.
Great
yeah,
movie.
That was a great movie. I think he did a great job. He sang everything. He got so much into character. He looked like him.
Hey, is he one of those actors that does the character even when he's not on set? You know, you've seen some of the guys.
Yeah,
they
some of them stay in character all the time. Yeah. I don't know.
Like some of them can't let go of their character.
Because he
stuck
did an exceptional job of that, man.
He did.
Yeah, really, really good.
I'm sure he did all the drugs and everything that was in the movie. He was probably doing that anyway. But the great Val Kilmer.
Yeah.
Wish him well. He's
struggling
a little. So.
Yeah, get better, brother.
Great movie, though, The Doors.
About Rockstar.
Love Rockstar.
Who
Mark
doesn't
Wahlberg.
Love Rockstar?
Mark Wahlberg did a great job. There's great musicians that are part of that movie that we all grew up and know and love.
I used to could do that scream back a long time ago.
I can. You want?
Well, you probably still
right
could.
Now,
no,
right?
No.
I do it.
I used to could. I can't, man.
I can nail it right now if you want me to.
No, too much. So.
But that was great 80s band. Great. You got a great look at behind the scenes when you're a rock star and how they live and what they get to do and craziness that goes on.
And I heard y'all say that Mark Wahlberg did not do the singing on that.
He did
correct?
None of the singing on it, except when they did a blooper where they actually played part of his Marky Mark stuff, and he didn't know it was coming up.
Vibrations.
That's a great blooper.
Wow.
And part of that movie. So Don't but go out there. If you haven't seen it, go check out Rockstar.
Who was the band that did the music, though? Y'all were talking about that earlier.
Well, there's multiple people in it. I know Zach Wild was part of that. We talked about
Zach Wild, Jeff Pilson.
There were some other people that wrote the songs and performed them, and they just all got up and lip-synced them. So, still did a great job.
Amazing.
Looks amazing. And, you know, you can't go wrong with Jennifer Aniston either. So.
Yeah.
This is true.
This is true. Very cool.
And then Dan brought up Rock of Ages for some reason.
Yeah!
I'm not sure why. I'm telling you right now, Tom Cruise.
Oh, he's terrible.
He couldn't sing The Righteous Brothers and Top Gun, and he definitely can't sing Def Leppard and Rock of Ages.
No, but he can't, but that's what makes the movie
really
so freaking hilarious.
He really tried to look the part. He really tried to look like he had long hair and he was a rock star.
Yeah,
so.
It was kind of that tongue-in-cheek style movie, though.
Yeah, just, I call it Mission Impossible because he was never good. That's like Mission Impossible 7, Rock of Ages.
Right.
So,
wow.
Anyway, not one of my favorites. I did watch it. It's more of a musical to me than it was a movie
it
about
is a musical.
Rock band. But plenty more. Bohemian Rhapsody. That
there
was
you go. Great movie.
Man,
that was definitely good.
Did they do an incredible job? They looked so much like them. The guys they got to play, the guitar player, the bass player, the drummer, they all looked. And what a behind the scenes, probably very accurate on what happened to Queen when they recorded. And the funny thing was Mike Myers was in there, who was in Wayne's World, that was singing
the whole song. Yeah,
and yet he's like, nobody's going to drive around and sing this stuff. He said that in the movie Bohemian Rhapsody when he's in Wayne's
right
World and they drove around and sang the song.
That's so, right, he did.
Great movie. Did a great job. Very touching story. Unfortunately, it was a great loss to lose Freddie Mercury. But great movie.
Yeah,
and then, of course, my favorite of all time.
Mine too.
Spinal Tap. Come on. If you haven't
it.
Seen Spinal it, Tap, you're not even on this earth.
It's a specific type of humor. Let's put it like that.
It's really making fun of the 80s music, making fun of these guys. There's some great scenes. 95% of that movie was ad-lib. They were making it up as they go along. And they actually performed and wrote the songs and learned to play the instruments. Harry Shearer never played bass before, and he actually plays bass in them. So Christopher Guest.
So he learned just for the movie?
Just for the movie.
Wow.
Right. And they actually went on tour after they made that movie, and they actually made a second movie that it's very, very hard to find, and I actually have it on DVD. So if you ever want to see that, it's pretty
good. My goodness.
But Spinal Tap. So anybody else got one they'd like to throw out there?
Yeah, Crossroads.
Yeah.
Crossroads.
There you go.
Incredible job on that movie.
Yeah,
and
he did. That was a good one. That was
Steve
a good
Vai,
one.
Steve Vai, Y-Coder. Yeah, that was good stuff right there, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, and any of y'all out there, if you're on here with us and you've got your favorite movie, let us know. We'll talk about it. They'll let us know what it is, and we'll be glad to talk about it and tell you how sorry yours is.
What about
your music?
What about heavy metal?
That was ahead of its time.
Way back there.
Sammy Hagar.
Was that animated?
Yeah.
That was an animated movie, right?
Yeah.
I remember that.
What about Stars Born?
That's been remade three times.
Yeah.
You got to give it up for Lady Gaga.
So which version? I like the latest version. That's my favorite.
I do too. I mean, their performance in that, and of course, her songwriting and singing is just off the charts.
Oh, man, I agree.
I just thought all in the movie.
He actually did way better than I thought.
He did,
You know, when I found out it was going to be him, I was like, oh, man, it's a disaster.
He really did a good
Bradley
job,
Cooper
man.
Tried to really get up there and sing, and he did sing all of his parts, so... Yeah. Got to give it up for that. That's really hard to do. Like
when you
Tom
do your
Cruise.
Own stunts, man. I'll give anybody props when you do your own stunts.
Yeah, Tom Cruise is a great example of that. And Bradley Cooper did an okay job. I like
Chris
Christopherson and Barbara Streisand, who are both very, very, very talented people.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
Really
rider. Chris Christopherson's an amazing rider, too.
What about you? I thought you mentioned Pure Country, George Strait.
That's a great movie. It was actually shot in Fort Worth and out west of Fort Worth, if you notice that. That was all shot locally. Very good movie. I thought it was a great portrayal of record companies and what they make these poor guys do and what they go through.
Used to,
yeah. Well, Dusty was not his favorite character in that movie. So, but for its time, I thought that was really good. George Strait's not an actor. And he definitely proves that in that movie, but he was great. nice guy. And, you know, he's nice looking, very handsome guy. So
thank you.
Especially with the ponytail, I was really digging that.
Right.
But, you know, get the ponytail back. But anyway, good movie too. I don't know if we've heard from anybody out there that's listening, but throw one out at us. We'll talk about it. We'll throw darts at it, whatever you want us to do.
They might throw darts at us.
Or throw darts at us. We're good right now. Let's just do it.
I want to mention one.
Do it.
I know that y'all told me it's not a rock movie, but if you love rock music, you've got to see A Knight's Tale with the late Heath Ledger. Miss Sandium. But the music in that movie is top notch. It's great. I like the twist on it, what they did with it.
That was really cool. I agree. Yeah.
Very uniquely filmed where they're incorporating like more modern music into medieval.
You know, with that said, I'm going to pitch this out here, too. If you don't, people who aren't in the music industry and aren't doing what we're doing, we do this because we love this. I'll promise you that, because the money ain't here right now. But if you think about this, the music and the sounds that you hear every day, they influence you so, so much of your feelings, of your emotions, every moment of every day. And if you don't believe that, mute the TV. Sit in silence for about 30 minutes. I can't take it. It's hard to do. So music is so powerful, and that's part of why we're here today, trying to bring you more music and more music channels and music information and have a little fun with it too. So anyway, just my big piece there.
So if anybody's out there and listening to Jack and thinks you can help him a little bit with this, because obviously he needs to address some issues here. But please make sure you leave a phone number
music,
or contact information.
Hey, somebody turn the radio on.
Have you ever heard the song The Sound of Silence?
Yeah,
try that.
Yeah, no.
Yogurt
would be really good for you right now.
Some yogurt with yoga?
Yoga.
No, man, even yoga, though, they got like some soft, new smooth jazz or something. You know what I mean? I play smooth jazz while I'm working. So, you know, that's kind of my
go-to. Kenny G is not in the playlist.
He might pop up on there every now and then. It's not bad.
All right, fair enough.
Okay, I digress. Right. Well, that's another show. What do you listen to? For a movie, so.
Hey, we just wanted to talk a little bit about movies and engage with y'all, and hopefully y'all will engage with us, too. I think we're about to listen to some more of us playing live, though. So
Steph's about to take the mic.
Steph's about to sing one of her great songs, and always love to see that and play along. So it's great talking. We'll see y'all.
See ya.
Later.
It's Dan from the Jack Tasty Experience, and I'm here with my brother
Juan. What's up?
Wow.
Unrehearsed.
Yeah, totally unrehearsed. Bro, I get the pleasure of listening to you play, you know, every show, every studio session, every time we do one of these. Let's talk about that guitar, man. I've always been a Les Paul guy, but that one's got some mojo. Let's hear it.
Well, this is a 50s Les Paul, which means it's got a thicker neck. I love the thicker neck. Put a lot of acoustic, so when I go to electric, easier transition. Got some Burstbrucker pickups here. Got the classic gold top color here. Got this thing at the Tone Shop in Addison. Got to check it out. It's a good
spot.
So it weighs about, I believe, about 8 pounds, 10 ounces. It's pretty heavy. You know, but with that, you just get a lot of sustain, a lot of full tone, you know. You get a classic, just a great rock and roll sound. When you switch to the neck pickup, you can play a lot of jazz with this thing as well. So it's a pretty versatile instrument. So it's my favorite guitar. I love the tone. Just good overall. Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds amazing.
Yeah, I love it, man. So what do you got there? He got this a few months ago. I fell in love with it. I want one for myself.
I did. Let me tell you a little bit about this. This is my CR Alsip Tejas. And CR Alsip is a company founded by Jake Willoughby. In case you wanted to know, CR stands for Connie Ray, for his mother. Jake hand builds all these guitars. They are hand built top to bottom, 100%. He carves and shapes his own necks, does his own bodies. Unbelievable. Best playing guitar I've ever had. some of the guys, I mean, and he builds some, he builds instruments for some pretty heavyweight players, guys like Bill Leverty from Firehouse, Frank Hannon from Tesla. He even did one for Phil Collin of Def Leppard. But this thing's just amazing, man. It's maple neck, sugar pine body, which is unusual. We've got Lawler pickups in this guy, which is
nice.
You know me. I'm a Seymour Duncan Jackson Floyd Rose guy. I mean, this is, this guitar is a complete departure from what I would normally play. But I got to tell you, it's absolutely amazing. It's lightweight, sounds incredible, plays faster than any of the Japanese Super Strats I've ever done, whether it be Charvel, ESP, Jackson, Ibanez, so on and so forth. It's just an amazing guitar. And if you want one, go check them out, crlsip.com, and Jake will build one for you. But yeah, I just absolutely love this thing, man.
Love it. It's, and it looks awesome.
And look at the look on this thing.
Yeah.
This is all hand-done. I can tell you who did the design on this. The designs are done by, they're all done by hand. None of this, the body CNC routed, of course. But all the design work is done by hand by, I believe, Jake's wife. Yeah, she handles all the paint. She handles all the carving, all the design. And I just love it. I mean, it's an amazing playing, sounding instrument. Always in tune. Sounds killer. Love it.
For the Jack Tasty Experience, it's a great combination of sounds. You got the more warmer sounds, and you got the brighter Tele sounds. So it's a good combination. I love the way we sound together.
Yeah, it sounds killer. I guess next time, next time when we come up here, let's walk them through our rigs on how we're getting that sound. Sound good to you?
Sounds great to me. Got a lot of pedals to talk about. So and he's got.
I have one.
Mine weighs 100 pounds. His weighs.
Mine doesn't.
So we'll talk about that next time.
All right, guys. Once again, it's Dan from the Jack Tasty Experience here with Juan, and we will catch you next week. Later.
To tell you about our new Jack Tasty Experience show that is streaming live on the internet. We are got multiple platforms. It's trying to get as many places as we can. We want to invite you to come check it out.
We're going to have live music, us playing live music for everyone.
More live music. Can't wait to bring it to you. Lots of cool stuff. More live music. We got some more Q&A. More live music.
We're going to have live music, us playing live music for everyone.
We're going to be giving away some stuff.
Some good merch.
More live music.
We'll definitely do some equipment rundown of what we use, how we record.
More live music. Yeah.
We're looking to get some live guests in here, other live bands. Maybe we can get them in here to play some music for y'all as well.
Yeah, that'd be real cool. Maybe come in right here in studio and jam with us. So lots of stuff coming your way. Y'all stick around. It's going to be the Jack Tasty Experience. Streaming to your local internet source. Y'all come check it out. Peace.
All right, thank y'all, everyone. We're now going to do a classic rock song, one of our favorites. It's our nice version with our lovely Steph singing. This is Gold Dust Woman.
Come on.
Looks like that's the end of the show. Thank y'all for being here. We appreciate you checking out the new music show with the Jack Tasty Experience. We can't wait to bring you more stuff. Next time, put on some headphones, check it out. I promise you, it'll be a lot better experience. Today's show brought to you by Corona, TC Helicom, Shure Microphones, and
us.
And the band. And the band. So y'all come back next week. It'll be every Sunday at 1 o'clock is what we're shooting for. Your local media source. We're getting on all of them, so wherever you are, we'll be there soon if we're not already there now. I guess that's it. Anybody got anything else? Y'all good?
No.
Everybody happy? Y'all have a great week. We'll see you next week.